My Doomspell trilogy is about two children, brother and sister, Eric and Rachel, who are dragged from the cellar of their house into this freezing cold world of ice and snow, which is ruled by a witch. And this witch has been imprisoned for centuries on this world for something terrible that she did to every single child on our planet a long time ago. I'm not going to tell you what she did, you have to read the books to find out. But in any case, it's so awful that three wizards take her and they imprison her forever on this planet. But while she's there, she doesn't just feel sorry for herself, she starts to form a spell. And when I wrote the Doomspell, I was actually reading a lot about spell making. And I noticed that particularly in children's books, that spells tend to be fairly simple. There's often a kind of an incantation word, a very Latin sounding phrase like Lumio, and the light comes on, and people pick up magic wands and move them around. It tends to be fairly simple like that. I wanted magic to be a little bit more difficult, a bit more complex to perform. And this witch takes about 200 years to form this spell. It's a finding spell, and eventually she surrounds her body with it, and then she sends it out across the universe, looking for one person with enough magic to help her get off this world so she can take her revenge on the wizards. And finally, the spell reaches our world, and she starts kidnapping children, one at a time, from our world into hers. Now, in my Doomspell books, all children have some level of magic. Some have hardly any. A few, a chosen few, have a really enormous amount of magic, but none of them know about it. And the reason is that the wizards have suppressed it. They've prevented children from using it, mainly because they don't trust them to use it wisely. But the witch knows how to release it, and when she does, she starts to test the children who arrive. And eventually, she comes across Rachel. And almost accidentally, at the same time, her brother Eric. When they arrive, and she begins to test Rachel, and Rachel passes one particularly deadly test that nobody's ever passed before, the witch realises she's found just what she wants, a companion who can help her get off this world. And the question is, can Rachel and Eric and the other children in this world somehow resist this immensely powerful witch and find their way back home?